I just want to read a brief statement and then make a point. This is from a Chinese woman who is fighting a prosecution. She says, I was working on my own from my house. My mother came to visit in November. The police came to my home in December and arrested me and my mother and charged us with brothel keeping. I am now fighting this case. If clients were criminalized and I couldn't earn money in this way, I would never have been able to escape from my violent husband. This is why I demand decriminalization of prostitution. When she came to stay, my mother didn't know what I was doing, and now she hardly speaks to me. And this is the reality of what actually goes on with this legislation. Now, Nicola from Women Against Rape spoke about prosecuting rapists instead of clients or sex workers. And the fact is that violent partners are also getting away literally with murder, literally, and nothing is happening to them. The conviction rate on domestic violence is about 7%, which is pretty much the same as the conviction rate for rape. So there's plenty for the police to do, which they're not doing, because frankly, from their point of view, it's a lot more fun, a lot more exciting, and a lot more corruption enabling to prosecute sex workers and a lot of money they can steal, and have the media with them and all them be the big heroes. Now, I just wanted to remind us that Tony Benn is being buried tomorrow. Yes. Now, many of us knew Tony Benn, in all kinds of different contexts. And I want to relate that in 1982, when the English collective of prostitutes occupied the church in King's Cross, the Holy Cross Church, and a number of us were there, quite a lot of us were there, Tony and Caroline Benn came to see us in the church to offer their support. And they were extraordinary, because they supported sex workers just like they would support any other worker. That was their attitude. They didn't come to preach, they didn't come to rehabilitate, they didn't come to lecture. Some others did. But not Tony, and certainly not his wife. And they came to say, how can we help? And immediately Tommy got his little dictaphone, which he carried with him everywhere, and said, what do you want us to do? And we said, we need you to write some letters to the Home Secretary and tell them about what's going on, about police illegality and racism against sex workers here. And he immediately, in front of us, dictated these letters. And we said, well, it's not quite accurate. And so he went back, click, 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 and corrected what was inaccurate. And that's how Tony Benn behaved, and that's why tomorrow I hope thousands of people are going to line the street between the Houses of Parliament and St. Margaret's Chapel when during his funeral. And his wife was also fantastic. And I'd like to also remember another person who had no connection to sex work as far as I know, but was also just buried, and that's Bob Pro, who also fought for the workers he represented, in this case, also low-wage and non-wage workers, and he signed our petition for a living wage for mothers and other carers. And not too many trade unions have done that. Yeah. So for Tony Benn, and for Bob Pro, and for Caroline Benn, who died some years ago, a big